Packs are collections of sounds and presets that you can use in live. In this video, we're going to have a look at how packs are structured.
The packs section is located in the places section of your browser. You can click the arrow next to the icon of the pack to reveal the pack's contents. Let's go through all the folders of the core library pack. The first folder is labeled Audio Effect Recs. All sounds and presets can be loaded by drag and drop from the browser. Audio Effect Recs are a collection of several different audio effect devices grouped into a rack with 8 macros to adjust parameters. The next folder is labeled Devices, which is further split into audio effects, instruments, and MIDI effects. Audio Effects contains all audio devices in Live. If you click on the arrow next to the device, you can access the device presets. If you'd like to load the default of a device, drag and drop the device from the top level. The folder Instruments contains all instrument devices in Live. If you click the arrow next to the device, you're able to access the presets. The third folder contains all MIDI effect devices. The next folder, labeled Drums, contains all drum rack presets. If you select a drum preset without loading it, then you can hear what it sounds like in the preview bar. The next folder is labeled Samples, which is organized into several categories. If a sample is selected but not loaded, the sample can be previewed in the preview bar. If I drag and drop this loop into an empty space within my live set, an audio track will be created, and I can play this drum loop as a clip. The next section in this pack is labeled Sounds. Sounds is also organized into subcategories. The Sounds section contains all instrument rack presets. Instrument racks can be a combination of instruments, effects, and MIDI effects contained in an instrument rack, which also has 8 macros for the control of mapped parameters. The last section is labeled Swing and Groove. In each of the subfolders, there are groove files. Groove files can be used to add swing to MIDI or audio clips. You can select a groove file from the browser and simply drag and drop it on a clip to add swing to that clip. If you'd like to use several groove files within a live set, you can open the groove pool and drag the groove files directly into the groove pool. The different groove files can then be selected using the chooser in the detail view of clips. Let's now have a look at a different pack within the packs collection that I have. In this Beat Tools pack, I have an additional folder labeled MIDI Clips, which contains MIDI clips from the pack which I can load into my live set. If these clips are loaded, they'll also load their respective preset sound. I have another additional folder labeled Sets. This folder contains Ableton Live Sets. If I click the arrow next to the live set, I have access to all the tracks within that live set.